Hi, this is Mike. Welcome to our channel Mini PC Tech, everything about Mini PCs. This video will be covering our top 5 picks for affordable Mini PCs for under $150. Enjoy the ride! Mini PCs are small but powerful computers that don't take up a lot of space but can do a lot of what desktops and servers you said to do for a fraction of the price. They are all not created equal. Some are good because of price, some because of size, some because of performance, some because of features. We hope to give you a few good options here to consider. If you like what you see here, let us know you like it and comment below. Be sure to subscribe to get future videos. What should you expect from a $150 mini PC? Before we dive into each option, let's explore what you should expect from a budget mini PC. First, it's not going to be great for gaming or any function that requires a lot of processor power. Most of these run on slower processors and smaller amounts of memory. But what they can do might surprise you. They can support at least one 4K display. No 8K displays. They all support Wi-Fi, but only 2.4G and 5G. None of them support the latest Wi-Fi 6. Only the lowest priced unit does not support a direct Ethernet connection. Ethernet is a great feature because it gives you more network stability than Wi-Fi, but the one that doesn't support it is a stick, so that's the trade-off. They all support Bluetooth, but not the latest version. This should not be a problem today, but you need to be aware of it. You won't find a Mac Mini among these minis, by the way. The Mac Mini is an excellent mini, I own 3 of them. But the lowest price Mac Mini is at least 3 times the price of any of these minis. You also won't find any gaming computers here. Maybe retro games like Pac-Man or something, but don't expect this to respond like a $1,000 gaming console. All but one supports Windows 11, which is safe because Windows 10 support is going away in October 2025 according to Microsoft. But because of the requirement for special hardware called ATPM, that might be a challenge for stick PCs. In fact, the stick PC runs Windows 10. What you do get is a small footprint unit that doesn't take up a lot of space, can be portable in the sense that you can take it with you from place to place, and at this price point is excellent for light tasking or a single use like video server. Now let's talk about our picks for the 5 affordable mini PC under $150. First, we have the GMKtec Mini PC, a middle of the road entry. Then, the BMax B1 Pro, our low priced cube mini PC. The PELADN WI4 is a mid-range unit that checks all the boxes, has more storage than GMKtec and is a little thinner. Next, we will look at the Beelink Mini S. Right now it is the least expensive of all the cube minis we are looking at. Finally, the AIOEXPC S5 Stick Mini PC. This is the highest price of all of our units, has the least features, but it's a stick PC which some people may love. Now we will go through our 5 picks for budget mini PCs in more detail. First, here is the GMKtec Mini PC. The GMKtec Mini PC is middle of the road for our picks in every respect but one. It's tiny. At about 3 inches by 3 inches by 1¾ inches, it fits comfortably in the palm of your hand and weighs less than half a pound. Still, it supports dual 4K displays, 8 GB of RAM, 3 USB, and 1 USB-C connection. Where it is a little light is that out of the box it only supports 64 GB file storage. For a few extra bucks, you can buy a microSD card and get another 64 GB of file storage. And with its USB connections, it makes a great server or light home desktop replacement. Then we have the BMax B1 Pro. The BMax B1 Pro is the lowest priced of all of the PCs that we are featuring. This would be a great starter computer. It's not the smallest or the lightest. but it's the least expensive. It also comes with a microSD slot for even more storage. The BMax Mini PC supports four USB connectors, two fast USB 3.0 and two less performant USB 2.0 slots. It only supports one 4K display. But if you need a second display, it has a VGA port for a second lower resolution display. For storage, it only ships with 128GB. You could expand it to up to 1TB if you want to do it yourself. But frankly, at that point, you might just want to buy a better mini. This is a great unit for a student or as a standalone video or file server. Now let's look at the PELADN WI4 Mini PC. This mid-priced unit has more storage than the GMKtec, has four high-speed USB ports instead of three, and you can expand the storage to up to 2TB. At 5 inches by 4.4 inches by 1.4 inches, it's not as small or as light as the GMKtec but has more features for the same price. Next, let's look at the Beelink WI4 Mini PC. This has the same features as the PELADN, but is a little less pricey. The Beelink product has a lot more traction than the others, which may give people a little more comfort. If you want to save a little money, there is an option for a unit with less storage for a little less money. Also, if you like this but want a machine with a little more power, there is an option for a mini with a better processor, more disk, more memory, and support for Bluetooth 5 and Wi-Fi 6 for around $50 more. Another advantage of this more pricey option is that it can support Ubuntu Linux. Finally, let's look at the AIOEXPC S5 Stick Mini. This is a full Windows 10 PC on a stick. It plugs into the back of a monitor with its HDMI connector. The AIOEXPC S5 is the most expensive of all of the five options at this time, and does not support Windows 11. It is also the lightest on storage, processor, and memory, and does not have a gigabit Ethernet connector. But it's a stick, and if you need something that performs a simple task and sits behind a monitor, it works. It can be used as a full computer as it comes with a fast USB port, a less performant USB port, and Bluetooth. So you can hook up a Bluetooth mouse and Bluetooth keyboard, plug it into a monitor, and still be able to connect two peripherals to it. So there you have it. 5 mini PCs that can bring you an inexpensive server. Or something to enhance a low-end entertainment center. Or maybe a light-duty home desktop replacement. If you would like to explore any of these, check on the links in the description. Be sure to subscribe to this channel for future videos about mini PCs. This is Mike, signing off, until next time.